quite resentfully. And do we
say more about your father-in-law?
My father-in-law was David Lobby, who was the most amazing man one could have.
The Prime Minister of New Zealand.
Yes. And he was, he and me spoke pretty much every day for a bit, mostly because I think I used to gossip and tell him everything that's happening with everyone. So we missed him very much. Yesterday was his death anniversary. There's not a single day that we don't think of him.
One of the most remarkable people I think I've ever interviewed, in fact, and I've never quite had enough time, no matter how much time you spent with him, you've never had enough time because there was so much more said. But either way, he then, instead of being a New Zealander wanting to get his family to New Zealand, thought that Melbourne was a fair compromise.
I think so, because I think he knew that maybe New Zealand would be, maybe might probably be, there'd be more reluctance, and so he kind of just said it as, hey, that kind of thing. So in a way, it was just, it turned out to be such a blessing, because Melbourne's been such a great home to Roy and me. We have a little daughter now. We have lovely friends. It's given us great opportunities. So, and the best thing about what I do is it keeps all my ties with India alive.
And Melbourne's Indian community, I don't know, I can't keep track. It's growing so fast, so vibrant, so diverse,
yes,
and making such an incredible contribution to the life.
I mean, if you come tomorrow to Federation Square, where we have the flag hoisting for the Indian flag at Indian Independence Day, I think you'll get to see a large part of the community in full force. Then we have the dance competition, which is going to be amazing. And that's when I feel so good, because we are at the pulse point of Melbourne, and we have people from all walks of life. It's so multicultural. We have many Australians who take part. And not only are they dancing to Bollywood songs, they're even lip-syncing, right, you know? So in that sense, you feel very happy, because you feel that, wow, it is really so nice that we have so many bridges across all the different cultures.
So your family back in India,
yes.
What did they make of their wayward daughter who just left to go into the
India? I mean, to be honest with you, my mother's here. She's helping out. Otherwise, it's very hard to do. Well, and she's listening, so hello, Mama.
Come on, everybody.
Hello, Mama.
Mother plays such an important role in this.
And she's, I think they still don't understand what I do, because we have a big family. So they say, oh, she's doing something this business, but we don't really know what it is, kind of a thing. But they're very supportive, she's quite supportive, and I don't think she still understands.
Well, here's your big chance laid out for us. Explain to us what someone does when they're the director of the Indian Film Festival.
So our core business is film distribution. So we distribute Indian films in Australia and New Zealand. And if there's any film shoots that happen in Australia, then we also have to find producers. So we've done some really big blockbusters like Jagdania, Manas, The Mayor of Mrs. Khanna, and so forth. And of course, my pride and joy is the Indian Film Festival of Melbourne, which is the big film festival that we put together, presented by the Victorian government.
And you can't have a bigger draw card than our first guest.
Yes, no,
there just isn't one. Do you want to introduce it?
Yes, please. It gives me great, great pleasure to welcome the one and only.
Hang on, just before you do, I think there's 130 people here. Have you noticed there's about 129 mobile phones suddenly popping up, pointing towards the floor? But do keep going.
Yes, the one and only Mr. Anil
Kapoor.
Requires obviously a great and high threshold
Making a film is
There's a developed part of India, there's an underdeveloped part of India, there's a bourgeois part of India, and there's an area and large parts of India of the whole country that are not there yet.
Absolutely. So our job is to educate them, and as filmmakers, as writers, as actors, and as leaders and politicians and industrialists, and that's what we try to do, is to educate them and help.
Turn it around as well. 22 minutes past 11 on the conversation hour, a special conversation hour at the Melbourne Recital Centre with an invited audience for the Indian Film Festival of Melbourne. Mitu Bhowmick-Lange, my co-host from the Indian Film Festival, and Anil Kapoor, the star of Slumdog Millionaire and lots of other films, as our first guest this morning. And one of the things the Indian industry, the film industry, does so well is it packages a version of India for international consumption. It feeds to the rest of the world's view of what India is still like. So Slumdog Millionaire, in a way, it's a lovely, inspiring story, and everyone goes, yay, that's great, it's a fairy tale and all the rest of it, but India's actually moved on a lot. I'm wondering, when do we get a film that could be set in Chicago or could be set in London, but it just happens to be set in India?
I think we have screening, why don't we come and watch it? Successful billionaire, and it's based on a dysfunctional family. And if you don't watch the film,
Sick of being typecast as this or that or the other. Are there
there particular genres or particular types of films that Anil Kapoor says, look, I'm determined I'm going to do a, I don't know, a James Bond style film. I'm determined I want to do a this or that or the other. Have you got any of those that you really want to do?
I would love to work with some independent films, which are out of the box, which make me uncomfortable, which I feel I want to put it off. And I feel that within Andy, and the director, the young director comes to me as this surrogate emotion. Like, even a film like this that I think, though, I was, you know, quite skeptical about it. But the filmmaker, Zoya, she's a young filmmaker, and who's always made films for, you know, which are loved by the youngsters. And she's one of our finest filmmakers. And she just pursued me. She says, I'm not leaving unless you say yes. I said, what did you say? I said, you had to. I said, give me a choice. You know, that's... She said, so I would love to work with these kind of passionate filmmakers and young filmmakers who would challenge me and make me do things which I'm uncomfortable with.
And where does that drive come from? Because a lot of people with your level of success have been known to sit back and say, okay, that's it, I've done pretty much anything I think I'm going to do.
Ladies and gentlemen,